In this video, I'll show you how to map spoof file detail lines in the designer of Interform NT2. For this, you have two prerequisites. First, you need to load a sample spoof file in the designer, and you also need to set up your template to run through all pages of the input spoof file. And I'll include links for both in the description below. For the actual mapping, I'll show you two solutions. First, I'll do a very simple map where I use a table and map all detail lines in separate columns in a table row. But I'll also show you a more advanced example where I'll use a repeat to iterate across the detail lines and add one table for each line. And then it's very simple to add also conditions if you have multiple layouts of your detail lines. When we run through the detail lines, I'll create a variable and iterate across those lines so I can use the variable to keep track of the current spoof file line. Here I've loaded a demo sample spoof file with some detail lines starting here at line 31, and then we have 13 detail lines. I've already mapped a window of data, and now I'll add a table, 5 columns. And in each of these columns, I want spoof file data. Here in the first column, I want the leftmost column of my spoof file. Add a text. In the text, I'll refer to an expression, magnifying glass, and map the leftmost column. Click OK and apply. This font is a bit large, so I'll just reduce that, size 10. And for the next column, I'll just continue the same. Expression, detail. Glam, and continue with this for all of the lines. The table I can of course move down, and I can also resize the size of the table here to make the columns as wide as I like. That is a simple way to handle detail lines. Another way is to iterate across the detail lines and have a dynamic layout. Instead of the simple table that I just showed you, I will now show you a more advanced repeat where I'm going to iterate across the detail lines and add a table for each detail line. And this way I can make a more dynamic layout of the input detail lines if they should have different layout from line to line. So the first detail line is line 30. So I'll assign a variable to 30. Line 30. And now I want to iterate across all of the detail lines. And we have here line 30, and we have up to 13 detail lines. So that's why I want to add a repeat. 13. Apply. Inside of the repeat, I want to add a table. 5 columns. And each of these columns, I can now insert a text. So for instance, here in the first column, I want to add a text. Double click, expression. Now I want to refer to the data of the spoof file, for instance, the first column. Click OK, and here you see the interval of positions and the to and from line. The lines should refer to the variable that we have defined up here called line. So that's why the 30 here should be deleted, and instead we want the line variable. So it looks like that, and also for the other one. And apply. I can move on with the other columns. Add a text. And do the same again. Final thing is that for each repetition, I also want to increase the value of our variable. So line should be increased with 1. So it's line plus 1. Apply. And now we can do a preview to verify how the final merged result will look. So we have on the first page 2 detail lines, and here we have 6 detail lines, and here we have the fourth and final page.